minimum wage. What is it? Better yet, what should it be? So minimum wage is the amount of money that a employer is legally required to give an employee to do their job. Now, what should it be is what it was founded on, and that was the fact that minimum wage should be the minimum amount of money a employee should receive that will allow them to sustain their life as a single individual. Now, this unfortunately is not the case because of inflation has been increasing exponentially without stopping, but minimum wage has tried to do the same but has failed. When it comes to their rates of increase, minimum wage is so much more slower in comparison than inflation. Now this causes a lot of issues. And so what I would like to persuade you guys today is to increase the minimum wage in order to combat the rate of inflation to where we can regain the true meaning of what minimum wage is. And I'll do that by giving you guys a brief history over minimum wage and inflation, as well as talking about the pros and potential negative side effects that can come with increasing minimum wage. So to start off with this, I will cover this article by Cornell Law School, which is a small research engineering group that collaborates with computer scientists, government agents, as well as legal scholars. And one of the statements that they said was the definition of minimum wage, and that was it was being the minimum amount an employee can receive to where they can live off of it and maintain their health as well as their well-being. Now, just to give out some statistics of minimum wage and how it has changed throughout history, I'm going to be starting off with 1968. Now, the reason I'm choosing to start off with 1968 is because that is where minimum wage peaked. Minimum wage peaked almost 60 years ago at $1.60 at that time. Now, that doesn't seem like much, but $1.60 in 1968 equates to $12.12 in today's money. Now, as we can see, after that peak, it has slowly gone down with little blips up. And the next number to point out that is also significant is 2009. Now that's significant because that was the last time minimum wage increased at $9.99. And you see that red line there? It has regressed. Now how is that possible? Because the dollar amount hasn't changed, but what has changed is inflation. And because inflation has increased so much and minimum wage hasn't changed at all, it actually decreased the value of minimum wage. And here's a fun number, 40% less is the value of minimum wage now than it was back in 1968. And this minimum wage being so low has had many negative side effects. But what can minimum wage do as a positive? Well, a study was done about increasing minimum wage by Jennifer Rumick, who was a bachelor's and master's in economics, and Heather D. Hill, who has a PhD in human development and social policy. Now, the article they wrote was called Coupling a Federal Minimum Wage Hike with Public Investments to Make Work Pay and Reduce Poverty. This was published in 2018. And in the study, they explained how with many other taxes being either slowed or paused for a couple of years, and increasing the minimum wage to 12% or $12, a family of four was able to get out of the poverty line. Now here's the issue with that poverty line. I'm gonna just throw out a couple more numbers here. 11.7% and 37 million people. That's the amount of people in America who are under the poverty line, who are not able to sustain a livelihood because they're below that line. Now, minimum wage has more to do than just your financial status. It affects many employees' mental health. And with the increase of minimum wage, we can see signs of depression, signs of alcoholism, smoking, and other mood suppressant drugs decrease in employees because of the increase in minimum wage. There was a study done by Aaron Reeves and David Stuckler, who are both members of the Department of Sociology, as well as Martin McKee, Johann Machenbach, Margaret Whitehead, and these are all members of the Department of Public Health. and this is called the introduction of a national minimum wage, reduced depressive symptoms, and low wage workers. This was republished in 2017, and participants who were in this study received a 10% increase in their minimum wage, and this showed a substantial decrease in depressive symptoms as well as drinking and smoking. Now here is some of the stats that they showed on this. Right here, this large increase. Well, on this y-axis here is the state of strain, the amount of stress these employees are under. Now right there, where it's high stat, these are the participants who did not get the 10% increase. Now if we look to the left, this right here, the smaller curve that is not as extreme, are the ones who received the 10% increase. And as we can tell, the ones who received the 10% increase actually experienced less stress due to more financial stability. Now, right here, we have the same basis, but for smoking. The y-axis represents cigarettes smoked. And as we can see, this large curve right here, that is the recipients who did not receive the increase in minimum wage, while this smaller curve did receive the minimum wage 10% increase. And this just shows that an increase in the minimum wage drastically increases the mental health of their employees, because they no longer feel the need to have to induce themselves in mood suppressant drugs. Now, this also has shown increases in morale as well as work efficiency. Now, although there are many positives that come with increasing minimum wage, we have to address some of the potential negatives. So according to the article by Congressional Digest, who used a Supreme Court database called Effects of Increasing the Minimum Wage, explained how increasing minimum wage has a chance of reducing employees' hours and having them actually potentially fall under the poverty line as well. And it could also result in increased cost of products as well as hours cut and jobs lost. Now, that seems a little counterproductive whenever you're trying to get people above the poverty line and try to get them to be able to make more money. Now that's where we have to find out a healthy balance to where we can increase the minimum wage without having to decrease the amount of working hours, decrease the amount of manpower, and decrease the amount of staff on hand. So in order to do this, that is why Heather D. Hill and Jennifer decided to put a pause on the taxations in order to get the people who are below the poverty line above the poverty line. So I hope during this persuasive speech that I was able to persuade you guys to take a deeper dive into minimum wage and start thinking about ways to increase the minimum wage in order to decrease the amount of gap there is between the minimum wage and inflation, because minimum wage needs to regain its true meaning. It needs to be the minimum amount a person can make in order to sustain a healthy life on their own, to keep their health in check, their mental in check, and be able to live a satisfied life.